It is my month, but I don't know about you. I am celebrating. My voice will be heard. I will stand and tall. It is my month. People will gather to celebrate me in the name of Jesus. Lift your voice and begin to appreciate God for this wonderful month. Appreciate him. He's our Lord. He's our shield. Bless him for what he will do. Appreciate him. Tell him, Lord, I am so grateful. I am so grateful for what you have done, for what you are doing, even for what you are yet to do. Lift your voice and begin to appreciate this God. Lord, we give you all the glory. We exalt you, our Father. From January until this moment, it has been you, O God. Lift your voice and appreciate this God. Jehovah, we worship you. Give him beautiful name. Appreciate him. It's our shield, it's our buckler. Brahma, Maseta, Nozota, Kaba. Is that how you can do? Is that how far you can do? Worship him in the beauty of his holiness. Appreciate this wonderful God. Is our shield, is our God. Worship the Lord. Say, Lord, we are so grateful. We are so grateful, our Lord. We are so grateful, our shield. We are so grateful, our Redeemer. But the gifts of life will say thank you. But the gifts of life will say thank you. Elohim will thank you. Adonai will worship you. But what you have done will say thank you. How about the good hands he has given unto you? Lift your voice and begin to appreciate God. Lift your voice and appreciate God. Lord, I come before you this morning to say thank you. Over my children, I say thank you. Over my husband, I say thank you. For the word you have given unto me, Lord, I say thank you. For the good heart, Lord will say thank you. Lift your voice and appreciate God. Appreciate him. Is the arm? Is the homing? Lord, we lift our voices this morning. Mando Masekele, Reprata Sasatata, Bramo Masekelebo. I will say thank you. I will say thank you. Adonai, we worship you. Elohim, we bless you. We lift our voices this morning. We join the head as in heaven to say we are so grateful. Lord, we are so grateful. Lord, we are so grateful. Lord, we are so grateful. Dr. Jesus will say thank you. Jehovah Jireh will say thank you. Elohim will say thank you. Adonai will say thank you. Yanda Masikele Katokolebo. Nebrababa Masikelebo. Rimato Tatala Mosikelebo. We give you the glory. We give you glory, Lord. As we hung on you, we give you glory, Lord.
As we honor you, you are wonderful.
Yes, Lord.
You are worthy.
Beloved, things are happening. The Lord has kept you, he has kept me. It's not because we know how to pray. It's not because of our righteousness. It is not because we know him. But because his mercy has kept us. Lord, from January, I say thank you. Lord, from January, I say thank you. Do you know many has fired arrow? When he has kept you, he has kept me. He do not allow the arrow to land. Even the one that landed, they make them to be useless. Lord, we are so grateful. For every father in this house who say grateful. For every mother in this house who say grateful. For our children, Lord, who say thank you. This morning, we appreciate you, our God. The same route you drove through, some people drove through, they can never come back. Some went to bed, they don't wake up. Some are even afraid to go to bed at night because they don't know what can be called. Lord, here we have this morning to say thank you. We are here to appreciate you. It's not because of our intellectual, but Lord, we bow to you this morning to say thank you. It is all about you, God. It is all about you, our Lord. In Jesus' name, we have given this. We want to go before the Lord. Some silvers to say, have mercy upon me, Lord. For I am weak, heal me for her. Vespo, you are going to talk to God. Lord, I've come short of your word. I've come short of your word, oh Lord. The thought of my heart is simple. But Lord, I plead for mercy. I pray for mercy this morning. Anything that the devil might ask, oh Lord. Anything that will hinder me, Lord. Ask for the mercy of God. Ask for the mercy of God. We ask for your mercy. We ask your mercy, oh God. Let your mercy prevail over judgment. Let your mercy prevail every evil declaration. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. We pray. Psalm 13 verse 3, say, consider and hear me, O Lord. God, listen that ears, lest I sleep the sleep of death. You are going to talk to God, Father, as I cry to you this morning. Lord, you will hear me. He said, loving Father, he is. None of us here will hear the cry of our child and we ask like we don't know. Even if you do it, you are earthly person, but our God can never do that. You will talk to God, Father. In this past month, oh Lord, as I call upon you, Lord, you will hear me. Over that child, when I call upon you, Lord, you will hear me. Over that situation that I cannot talk to anybody, Lord, when I cry to you, you will hear me. Lift your voice and talk to God. As we cry upon you this month, oh Lord, we ask, oh God, you will hear. We ask, oh God, that you will hear us. We ask, oh Lord, that you turn things around. In the mighty name of Jesus, let your voice answer to God. Yada Jose Tebo, Liberato, Masema, Hila de Mosikaba. Lord, you will hear as we go. In the mighty name of Jesus, this is our motto. Commit today's service to God's sense. Lord, I need a touch. Touch me one more time today. Touch me one more time today, oh Lord. Let there be a turnaround, oh Lord. Speak to me today, oh Lord. As your servants on the professor, Lord, talk to me. Give him a word for me. Give him a word for me. As I declare, oh Lord, let it land in the good. What I granted in my life, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we just give it glory. We pray even as the choir mount the pulpit. Pray for signs and wonders. We pray, all of Father, you walk through all this morning. Holy Spirit is all about you. Come on. Holy Spirit is all about you. Move, Lord. Move, Lord. Let that sister go home be blessed. Let every shame be broken. Let every shackle be broken. Let those that are praying be set free. It's all about you, Lord. Lift your voice and talk to God. Let every chain be broken. Heal us, oh Lord, this morning. In Jesus' name, we pray. And so, Lord, we want to thank you one more time. It's all about you. We know your presence is already here. And when you show up, no one goes the same. When you show up, chains are broken. When you show up, chains turn to your face.
pray for. We are asked, oh Lord, that you speak to that sister problem. Speak to that brother's problem. I am most adorable. Is there anyone here, oh Lord, that is going through affliction that they did not know about? Father, we cause that problem now in the name of Jesus. Let's declare you set me no center libas. Going through anything that you not know about. Father, we declare liberty this morning. Because when your presence show up, liberation is in place. Set us free, oh Lord. I pray for my father and the Lord, oh Lord, as you speak this morning. Let him speak with authority. Let him speak with grace. Let him speak with unction, oh God, from the throne of grace. And Lord, we put every spirit that is not of you to shame. We put them under our feet. We tread upon them. We tread upon them. We say the church of God will march forward. And no power, no principality. Yeah. In Jesus' name we pray.
Come on, somebody praise the name of the Lord Jesus. The Bible says, clap your hands for people and shout in the voice of triumph. This is the first Sunday of the month of August. Come on, somebody. If you have your mouth, if you have your hands, lift up your voice, oh God, your people. And shout in the voice of triumph. Come on, somebody. And praise him with your hands. Praise him with your mouth. Come on, somebody. He, Father, we give you all the glory. We bless your holy name. James chapter 2, 23, he says, Abraham believed and he was called him the righteous of a friend, righteous to his own righteousness, and he called him to be his friend. Today we are about to boast about his glory and that he calls us his friend. Hallelujah, somebody. Hallelujah. Thank you.
My eyes are blessed. Give
is enough of his songs that we can sing, but we let you out and give him praise. Give him your fruit of your lips, huh? This is your unreasonable act of worship. What comes out of you, that is worthy. Enough of the songs, but let your praise go up. Lift up your voice and give him praise, give him praise, give him worship.
So the enemy, no one is permitted to open it. There is no one like you, our God. There is no one like you, our Jehovah. In Jesus' name, we have thanks. We are going to pray from the book of 1 Kings. 1 Kings, this is chapter and verse 38. 1 Kings, the chapter and verse 38. And it read thus, and in the 11th year, in the month of blue, which is the 8th month. This is the 8th month. Amen, somebody? Which is the 8th month. The house was finished in all its details according to all its plans. So he was 7 years in building of it. I don't know how long you have been trusting God for something. I don't know how long you've been dependent, but this verse says at that very 8th month it was done. Amen. So in this month you will accomplish. In this month you will succeed. In this month, I don't know what you have been trusting God for from January, and you are saying, God, it is 8 months already. It is how it's going to be. Oh my God, it's turning situation around now. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will not walk in vain in this month. Let your voice and begin to play. Say, 8 months here, the word of God. The month of August here, hear the word of God. In this month, I will accomplish. In this month, I will succeed. In this month, I will not walk in vain. Lift your voice and begin to talk to God. In this month, there shall be no loss. Lift your voice and talk to God. No more abandonment. Lift your voice and begin to talk to your maker. Talk to God, talk to God. Talk to God, talk to God. Talk to God, talk to God. In the mighty name of Jesus. All God, see, I hear the word of God. I will sustain this month. I will dominate this month. This is my month of turning around. This is my month of break. This is my month to pray for. Lift your voice and talk to God. You don't serve a dead God. You serve a living God. Is how much you love yourself? Is that all you can do? Oh, oh God, see, I hear word of God. For me and my household, we shall dominate. For me and my household, it is our turn to break forth. For me and my household, we are moving forward. We are marching forward. We shall accomplish. I don't know what you are trusting God for. This month, where you have been rejected, they will accept you with apology. Lift your voice and talk to God. In Jesus' name, we pray. So you are going to pray from the book of Isaiah, the very 51 chapter and verse 11. Isaiah 5:1 verse 11. Say, therefore, the rim of the Lord shall return and come with the singing into Zion. So in other words, what you have been, Lord, I don't understand. From January up to this moment, this is your month. This is your month. And you will not just come. And you just come with joy. You will come with joy. When somebody is with joy, that means the Lord has done it. You are going to talk to God. You are going to speak to that situation prophetically this morning. I don't know what you are trusting God for. You are speaking prophetically to that situation. That this month, this situation, I will rejoice over you. I will rejoice over you. No more crying. No more murmuring. Lift your voice and talk to God concerning you and your household. Concerning that child, you will rejoice. Concerning that job, you will rejoice. Concerning that marriage, you will rejoice. Victory is yours. We declare peace now. Peace of God that passes through understanding into every marriage that are shaken in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we pray. Revelation 13. Revelation 13. 10. The Bible says this, that he that lived into captivity go into it. You are going to talk to God. As you are planning the good for yourself and your family, so the other one is planning. He said, he that leadeth into captive shall do what? Shall go into captive. In other words, you are going to talk to God. Everyone that raised against me and my family this month, Lord, they will go for me. That is the word of God. He that leadeth into captive will go into captive. Lift your voice and talk to God. Every power that wants to wage war against me and my household in the month of August, you
you shall go for me. Everyone that wants to wage war against my children, you shall go for them. Every power of the wicked, lift your voice and talk to God. He that trouble you in this one shall be troubled. Lift your voice and talk to God. You don't serve a dead God. Anyone that dig a pit will fall into it. He that dug a pit will fall into it. In the mighty name of Jesus, this is the word of God for you. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Amen.
Now, you know, when someone had a child, you named the baby right. You want to christen this month. If you like, don't name the baby. But I have name for this month. Because this month is the month of my glory. It's the month of me turning around. It's month that I will hit that I've been praying for. You want to declare to this month one more time. Oh God, hear ye the word of God. My going out is blessed. I will get it this month. I don't know where you have been feeling, but this is your month. In this month, you will sustain. In this month, you will sustain. In this month, you will dominate. In this month, you will accomplish. In the mighty name of Jesus, this is our month, O Lord. We will sustain, O Lord. Financially, we shall sustain. Maritally, we shall sustain. Intellectually, we shall sustain. There shall be no cry. There shall be no weapon this month. We cancel every evil doctor report. In the mighty name of Jesus, we say we go forward. For whatever this month, back whatever. For whatever this month, back whatever. We declare domination. We declare domain over you and your household. Anyone that trouble your family shall be trouble. Anyone that trouble your marriage will be trouble. He that dug a pit for you will fall for it. In the mighty name of Jesus. Anywhere, oh Lord, your name is mentioned forever, the Lord will answer on your behalf. Let your voice and talk to God. Every power that will rest against me and my household this month, I destroy them, oh Lord. Let there be fire upon them. I get the fire. I get the fire. I get the fire. Every tongue shall rest against me and my household, oh Lord. I call them, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. In this month, I will dominate. In this month, I will stand and tall. In Jesus' name, we pray. As we declare, so shall it be. In Jesus' name, we pray.
of worship. There's an atmosphere of funeral. There's an atmosphere of disco. There's an atmosphere of party. When you come to this place and you sense the Holy Ghost, please don't sit down. Don't begin to say that what is happening. I sense the Holy Ghost and I don't know what you are going through. Come on, lift up your voice. This is my song.
I am Musalabutaya. My Lord, my way and my life and my aim, accept the praise I bring. Jesus, let's give him glory. He's worthy, amen. I'm going to let you go in no time, but before you do, I want to challenge you with a word from the book of God. I have some things I'm going to do today, but before we do those things, we want to trust God for the word of God. We have begun a word that says character and habit. Let me hear the word character and habit. We want to trust God that next week we will go into habit, because habit is something that we go into character, because it's something that without it you can't make heaven. Without you having character. When God said, I know Abraham, that he will command his children, not that he will beg them to come to church, or he'll beg, oh no, he said he will command them to know this God, or know the truth, or follow righteousness like you did. Because the blessing is packaged from the fathers. Immediately, the children don't want to serve the God of their fathers. Everything changes. So he said, Abraham, for the blessing to flow into the children that you have, you must command them. Can I hear command them? America is a free nation that people have their right. Maybe the child is 18, they say, I'm 18. Hello, daddy. But when it comes to God, you say, command. Let me hear the word command. Yeah, so today I'm not going to talk about command. We're going to continue talking about what is called habit. Let me hear the word habit. How many things we have given so far about habit? Let me say this as we give me the four things. One, habit is a daily routine. Can I hear daily routine? And everybody's life is dependent on what they do daily. What you do daily, whatever you do daily, it will determine whether you're going to succeed or not. You know, there was a guy, FBI, the most wanted terrorist, was killed during the weekend. You know how they got him? You know how the intelligence got him? His habit. Every morning, he's thrown down on the corridor, walking up and down. So the intelligent guy picked it up. This guy, every morning, this is what he does. They have been looking for him since Osama bin Laden time. Immediately, the intelligence guy got it. They send a drone, boom, got him and killed him. What you do daily has brought you to where you are. Like I said the last time, some of the things that we possess, whether it's our home or anything, if we don't do the things we do daily, we can't keep the home. If we don't do it daily. So today, I'm going to also bring doctor in, because there is something God said about our bodies that I want you to know. Praise God. But before that, give me the four things we have already talked about. Number one is what? Meditate on the word daily. Let's hear the word daily. Every day, the word of God must be something. Don't see, I don't preach. I don't study the Bible to preach. I study to live. I study to do what? I study to live, and I see certain things that God has said, and I say, okay, this is what my life is supposed to be. So Bible says, meditate upon the word day and night. Joshua 1:8. This book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth, but meditate therein day and night. That means it's a daily thing. Can I hear daily thing? That is one. Number two is what? Die daily. That means there are certain things that if you don't die, guess what? You're not going to get it when it comes to God. I was telling a young couple that I talked to yesterday and said, look, when it comes to God, he created the male and female. God created the male and female. But God has to form the man. In other words, if you want to operate as a man, you must come to a place where you are formed, where you go through some rough patches or rough things, and still you are standing, because I'm a man. Man is somebody who can be molded by God, because when you want God to mold you, it's different from when God is creating you. Hello? Oh yeah, when you took the dust and begin to put together, and a man became a living soul or breathing to him, he has to touch him here and touch him here and touch him here and touch him here, and then a man became complete. In other words, if you want to be a man, you must go through the process. Let me hear the word process. There are things you got to go through to be a man. We don't give our children to boys. We don't give our daughters to young men. We give it to men who have been molded by God. Let me hear the word molded by God. So that is it. If you want to be a child of God, die daily. How to die? It means there are certain things God is going to chop some certain things from your life. There are certain things you like that God will chop it off. You like this thing, chop it off, chop it off. At the end of the day, you say, it is no longer I that live, but Christ that liveth. Let me hear, I hear you. Because you can now declare that the life that I now live, I live by the faith of the Son of God who died for me and gave me this ability to live for him. So, number one again is what? Meditate on the word. Number two, die daily. Number three is what? Let me hear, pray daily. Prayer supposed not to be something that we declare in the church before you pray and fasting. It's part of the life. So, you must always pray daily. You can pray like Daniel, 3 times a day. Or you can pray like people that pray at least once. If you can pray 3 times a day, pray once a day. Now, like I said, the 3 times a day prayer, it doesn't supposed to be 3 hours every time you pray like Jesus, praying 3 hours for something to be turned around. See, there are certain kind of prayer that you have to learn. Because one time Jesus prayed and lifted up his hand and said, Father, I'm about to go. These people that you are leaving me behind, I want you to cover them. That prayer was no sweat. But the time came that he was praying, Luke 22, that the sweat of Jesus was like a clot of blood coming from his body. That means there's a levels of prayer that you must come to if you want to get certain things approved by God. Let me hear the word, I hear you. Not every prayer that, okay, I'm praying, God, give me this thing. No, there are certain prayer like that. But there are some prayer that it got to be a fight, warfare. You said that this thing should not happen. Praise God. So, 1, 2, 3. The fourth one is what? Rejoice always and again. I say the word, rejoice. I asked you a question last Sunday. How many of you that you like to go to work every day? You love your job and you want to go there every day. I mean, you love the job. Thank God you are, whatever job you are doing, you love it. But do you want to go there every day? None of us. But only the King Computer say, yeah, he want to go every day. I say, why? Because you're working for yourself. So at times, it's good like that. Amen? That means you don't have a choice about the matter. You have to rejoice every day. Oh, Pastor, no. Bible say rejoice, and again I say rejoice. So if you say rejoice, and again I say it, friends, double rejoice means double rejoice. That means rejoice, it doesn't matter what. Oh, my wife didn't do what I want, rejoice. My husband is saying something, rejoice. My brother is not doing this, rejoice. Oh, the church folks, they are this and that, rejoice. The thing is this, if it was me that telling you, oh, rejoice, then, oh, pastor is the one making me. But God said, rejoice always. 1 Thessalonians 5:16 and Philippians 4:4, he said, rejoice always, 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 always. Let me hear the word always. So today, we want to add few and then we go into the body part. We want to add few. Now, one of the things I want you to do is say, always abounding. Let me hear, always abounding. In the work of God. In the work of what? Because some of you are not abounding. You are born again and you don't do nothing for God. And you say, okay, Bible says always. Can I hear the word always? So if you are doing nothing for God, let me open my eyes to see you that you got to start doing something. Because one of the reasons why God delivered you, he said, Moses, go and bring them out from Egypt that they may serve me. So you don't have anything, okay, if I feel like it, you don't feel like it. God said, this is what you're going to do. So please, look at it. 1 Corinthians 15:58. He said, this is always do it. Always abounding in the work of God. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye what? Steadfast, unmovable. It doesn't matter whether the pastor say hello or not, whether the usher say hello or not, or disrespect you or not. The Bible says always abounding, never be unmovable, always be steadfast. Because the work of God always, let me hear the word always. Oh, do it today and tomorrow, don't do it. Oh, do it the time you want it. No, you see, always abounding in the work of God. Because you know that there's what is called rewards. Let me hear the word rewards. Your labor is not in vain. God will reward you. So do something on earth here. Evangelist Aldi was teaching us, and he talked about how people, a man that was so rich, but he had no treasure in heaven. Friends, do something that tomorrow, when you and I are not here, it will be recorded that this is what this guy did. Or this is what you did on earth here, so God will record, this is it. But if you do nothing, you are born again, and you are doing nothing in the house of God, you need help. Always abounding. Let me hear the word, always abounding. And then the next one is, speak with grace. Speak with what? In other words, know where you are, that it is only by grace you are where you are. So when you are talking to somebody, make sure it is only by, you speak with grace. Let your words be seasoned with salt. In other words, let your word be full of grace. Anytime you come to me, I will start my blessing, blessing, bless you. It means because I realize that, look, people are, it's better to be blessed than to curse people. So anytime you come, I want to know, what is the good news? What do you have? What do you want to tell me? They say, oh, daddy, God is good. I say, good, that is the good news. The next one is, okay, maybe I'm carrying this problem or whatever, but I want to hear the good news first. Always let your words be seasoned with grace. So that when those who are hearing will not be destroyed. You know, a man of God, Kenneth Hagin, he has gone to be with the Lord, powerful man of God. Somebody came to him to report another man to himself. You know what he was telling him? All what he was doing, he was just not, he did that? Ah, that was it. He didn't contribute to all what he was nodding his head, say, At the end of the day, he had a severe headache. And the headache, he now asked God, God, you have promised me I shouldn't be sick. Why should I have headache? And then God said, because somebody came to tell you a lie and you are nodding your head. So the devil nod your head. Allow the devil to nod your head. So listen to this. It is therefore important that you and I come to a place where whatever that we are telling people, it is something that is sorted and is full of grace. Let me hear full of grace. Look at it, the book of Colossians 4:6. It's let your speech always. Can I hear always? Anything you see always means it is something you have to have it. Habitually, it's a daily thing. You do it day by day, every day. Let your words, everything, seasoned by grace. Now, having said all of that, I have a few things, but I want to jump to what we're going to do today. It's bodily, how to take care of your body. You know, we have quoted a scripture from the book of Romans 12, verse 1. Romans 12 verse 1, you see, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your body, what? A living sacrifice as what? Holy and what? Now, I want to dwell the place holy and acceptable. Let's say together. If your body is supposed to be holy and acceptable, there is a certain way that you must live to have a body that is holy and acceptable. Now, I was asking my daughter yesterday, because I'm going to ask daughter to come in. I was asking my daughter yesterday, daughter, was pandan yam made for the people in America? And she said, everybody can eat it. I said, no. The people in America, there was no way pandan yam was made for them. Hello? The people in America, there's no way the word pandan yam was made for them. So if any time you eat pandan yam, you know that you are not in America. You are living in Africa. Because my father and my father's father and the father before my father, all of them were farmers. So what they were eating in those days were pandan yam. And they walk about 5 miles to work to their farms and walk 5 miles back. Think about it again. I'm going another level. So those people, they can eat pandan yam and sugar will not stay in their body. Hello? And now if you walk 5 miles in, 5 miles out, and then you go and we go to the farm, we have something called cutlass and something called and we use it like this, and we cut. So those food were prepared for them. So that when they finish eating, it digested. They don't need prayer. They don't need nothing. Now you sit in air-conditioned car, air-conditioned church, air-conditioned house. Everywhere you go is air-conditioned. You don't walk even 10 minutes a day. And you say, panda yam is what I'm going to eat. Hey, God will deliver us. See, there's some food that is made for people in the other side, though. Don't bring it here. If you want to eat it, do some exercise. The way they do it, I learned it from Pastor Matthew Ashimolo. He said, for the past how many years, he has never eaten rice. I say, rice. He said, I've never eaten eba. I say, then I'm going to help me, Lord, because that's my favorite. Hello? He said, I'm 70 years, and look at me. And I look at him at 70 years. And when I heard him say that, panda yam was given for the people from for farmers. And I know that's true for farmers. And you are not farming here, and you want to eat panda yam. God will deliver you. There is no way you can have a body that can speak to God or worship God or do the things God wants you to do. Jesus is the one that first said, my body is a temple. Before Paul came, Jesus said, I will break this temple in 1 day, and 3 days I will build it up. And when he rose up, the Bible said they remember that he was not talking about a physical thing, but he was talking about his body. Let me hear, I hear you. Friend, if your body is not corresponding to the Spirit of God or the Holy Ghost, it will surprise you that you have a bad habit. Some of us, we have bad habit. We eat late in the night. Doctor, don't let me take words from your mouth. Let's celebrate, doctor, as he come and tell us something that will help this our bodies.